There are no less than three different ways to control custom scripting in SharePoint Online. Three! And if that's not confusing enough, one of these isn't even on the screen. Let's go through each one of these so that you know which one to turn on or off depending on your situation. So first, let's cover the ones that you can actually see, the easier ones, and those are in the SharePoint Admin Center. First thing we're going to do is go into Settings. And since Microsoft hasn't brought these over into the modern interface, we have to go into Classic Settings. Once you're here, scroll down until you get to the Custom Script setting. There's two different ones, and at first glance, you may think they're the same thing, but let's take a closer look. The first one is to prevent or allow running custom scripts on personal sites. Personal sites is a terrible name in my opinion. What you should be thinking here is OneDrive sites. I'm not sure why it's referred to as personal sites because even in the classic SharePoint days, they were called My Sites. But in any case, what this is going to do is control the access in OneDrive to running custom scripts. And let's just take a minute to talk about custom scripting, what is called custom scripting. Don't think this is custom development. It doesn't necessarily mean custom development. So this isn't really SharePoint framework specific or PowerShell or things like that. It is some of the normal things you would do in SharePoint would require custom scripting. So enabling and disabling this thing actually does have an impact to your site owners and the site administrators. They're not going to be able to perform certain actions if this is turned off. And if you're looking at turning this off, you want to make sure that you communicate to those site owners so that they actually see what's about to happen and they have a little bit of an idea of the impact on their daily administration. So the second option here controls running custom scripts on self-service created sites. Now, I don't really ever see a tenant that has self-service site creation turned on unless it's by accident. Most organizations want this controlled so it goes through a particular process, possibly having an approval required. But if this is turned on, then users are going to be able to simply go to the SharePoint start page and they'll have an option to create a site right from there. Now, whether that's provisioned in the site's managed path or the team's managed path is controlled in SharePoint Admin. And I'll actually show you where that is. That's back in the modern area. Under site creation, you'll see the option here. So if this is turned on, then those self-service sites will either be under /sites or /teams. So this turns on the custom scripting for those particular sites. But what about the rest of the sites? I would say, what about the bulk of those sites? The ones that you've been creating in SharePoint Admin, your intranet, all the regular old sites. Where is that done at? Because they're not self-service and they're not OneDrive sites. Well, those are going to be found in PowerShell. That's the option that isn't shown on the screen. The reason why is because those modern sites automatically have scripting disabled. They're called no script sites, if you've seen that term, and you're going to have to manually turn it on a site by site basis to enable some of that functionality. Some web parts that you use will require this to be turned on, or it's just simply not going to work. So this is the more common scenario of when you need to turn on custom scripting. It's going to be done through PowerShell, and you're going to use one of these two commands to do it, depending on whether you're using the SharePoint Online Management Shell or PNP PowerShell. Whatever you're more familiar with, all you have to do is connect to the site and then run the particular command that corresponds to the method you connected with. So just a simple tip for this week and something that I wanted to point out because it's a very common point of confusion how you're supposed to enable custom scripting when the time comes. There's some feature that you need, there's a web part that you need to install, and it requires custom scripting. And how do you do this? I've seen people go into the admin center and they turn on the option and it has no effect on what they're doing. And it's because they chose the wrong option. So now you will know exactly where to go to turn on custom scripting when you need it. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more content like this.